Hey, it's Rod. I just wanted to make a quick video as a warning and explanation of the current state of Victron inverters in the UK when it comes to getting them signed off by your DNO. In the UK, any generation equipment like these inverters that is connected to the grid needs to be signed off by your local DNO through a process called G98 or G99. It depends on the size of the inverter. To keep things simple for the DNO, there's a register kept by an organisation called the Energy Networks Association, or ENA. The register tracks what equipment is compliant with G98 and G99, and it greatly simplifies the process of getting equipment approved by your DNO for connection. So I purchased these two inverters behind me mid-2022, and at the time they were on the ENA register as compliant, so everything was good. But for several reasons, it took me until mid-September to get the inverters installed and start the process of a G99 application. It was while completing the application form, I discovered that the Victron inverters I had were now listed as non-compliant for new installations, which is a bit of a bummer. After a bit of investigation, it turned out that changes in Amendment 8 of the G99 regs, which came into effect in September, had resulted in the change of status for the inverters. Victron have subsequently made several attempts to get their inverters back to a compliant state on the register without any success. I'm confident the situation will be resolved shortly, but as of today, it's important that you're aware that these inverters are not compliant. If you're considering buying a Victron inverter, as it stands, they can't be signed off by your DNO. Although I'm generally very happy with my inverters, I'm disappointed that Victron has really dropped the ball on this. My understanding is the changes in Amendment 8 have been known about for years and only came into effect in September. Victron's customers should never have been put into this situation. They've also done a really poor job of publicly communicating the situation. They've offered no apology, no explanation, no reassurance. I'm going to keep a pinned comment below that I'll update as the situation changes. Hopefully I'll be able to change that shortly to say that everything's fine and you can ignore everything in this video. If you found this useful, please hit the like button. It helps the YouTube algorithm do its thing. And a subscribe to the channel is always really appreciated. It'll stop you from missing any updates on my battery system or any of the other projects I'm working on. Thanks for watching and I'll catch you next time.